Wild summer gone. Namaste, welcome to the One Earth Yoga YouTube channel. My name is Evelyn and I'll be guiding you through a Hatha Basics class today. Begin by placing your hands on your knees, palms facing up, sitting nice and tall, shoulders relaxing away from the ears. Start to take a deep inhale, allowing the breath to fill up the lungs and the belly. And on the exhale, pressing all that air out, out, out. Inhaling completely, filling up the lungs, the belly, and exhaling, allowing all that air to come out. Last inhale, filling up completely, and exhale, pressing all that air out. Continue for a few more rounds of breath, making sure you use your breath wisely to help you get settled and calm into the practice. And slowly on the next inhalation, sweep your arms up overhead. And exhale, twist towards your right, part the hands, place your left hand in front of your right knee. Use your inhalations to lengthen, exhalations to twist some more. On the next inhalation, bring your arms back up. Exhale, twist towards the left, right hand in front of the left knee. Inhale to lengthen, exhale, twisting a little bit deeper. On your next inhale, reach your arms back up and exhale, release your arms by your sides. We'll go ahead and find an all four position, tabletop, making sure you stack your knees underneath your hips and your wrists right underneath your shoulders. Beginning with cat and cow, as you inhale, drop the belly down, pull the chest forward, looking up. And exhale, tuck the tailbone under, round the spine, push through the palms. Inhale, dropping the belly, pulling the chest through, looking all the way up, full extension. And exhale, rounding the spine, pushing through the palms. Move with the breath. Inhale, drop the belly, look all the way up. And exhale, rounding in, tucking that tailbone under. Last round, inhale, extending the spine, and exhale, rounding in. From here, come to neutral spine position, and we'll go ahead, reach the right hand all the way up towards the ceiling. On the exhale, thread the needle, bring your right shoulder, right ear down to meet the mat. Come up into fingertips of the left hand. You can stay here, or if you feel stable, you can sweep the left hand up towards the ceiling, wrap the arm around the lower back, and find the hip crease of the right thigh. Option to stay or start to float the left knee off the mat, curl the left toes under, and straighten the left leg out completely. Feel the twists in the spine and the stretch into that bottom shoulder. Slowly start to come back, release the left knee down, untangle the left hand, place it down in front of your face, push the ground away, and help yourself back up onto all fours. From here, switching sides, left hand goes up towards the ceiling, exhale, slide it right underneath your right armpit, left shoulder, left ear meets the mat. Come up onto fingertips of the right hand, choose to stay or sweep the right hand up towards the ceiling, wrap it around the lower back, find the hip crease of the left thigh. Gentle tug into the hip crease to roll that top shoulder open. Option to stay or straighten out the right leg completely. Then go ahead, drop the right knee back down towards the mat, untangle the right hand, press the mat away and help yourself back up onto all fours. We're gonna come into a little bit of a chest opener here. So take your hands wider than your yoga mat. Start to adjust the knees behind the hips and allow the hips to fall all the way down. Kind of like a lazy Sphinx pose here. You can also rock your head from side to side if that feels good for you and your body. Slowly exhale, press all the way back into child's resting pose, leaving your hands where they are, and come up onto fingertips and see if you can sink your chest deeper down into the ground in between the thighs. two rounds of breath here to get settled. Then go ahead, straighten the arms in front of you. We'll shift the body weight forward, come back up onto all four position. Take the knees back further than the hips, giving yourself some extra room here so that you can bend the elbows and drop the chest in between the hands, chin down, knees, chest, chin. Inhale, drop the hips down, peel the chest off the mat, low cobra. And exhale, press all the way back into child's resting pose. One more round. As you inhale, shift the body weight forward. As you exhale, drop the chest and chin down towards the mat. Inhaling, hips down, chest up. Exhaling, pressing back into child's resting pose. Inhaling, shifting forward. Exhaling, dropping chest and chin. Inhale, hips down, chest up. This time, tuck the toes back behind you and press yourself all the way back up into the first downward facing dog of your practice. Then go ahead, deep bend the right knee, straighten out the left leg, pressing the left heel down into the mat, stretching out the left hamstring. Switch sides, deep bend the left knee, straighten out the right leg, press the right heel down to stretch out the right hamstring. Then go ahead, straighten out both legs, find downward facing dog, and we'll start to walk the hands towards the back of the mat, landing yourself into a nice deep forward fold. And you can grab a hold of opposite elbows, and you can wiggle yourself deeper into your forward fold, and sway from side to side here with the upper body. Taking any movements that feel good for you. And you can also shake the head yes and no to release any tension that you have in the neck. Then go ahead, release the hands back down towards the ground and we'll inhale, take a halfway lift, straightening out your spine, making sure the lower back is nice and flat. And on the exhale, folding back down again. This time we'll sweep the arms all the way back behind us, interlace the fingers, and if you can, bring the base of the palms together and straighten the elbows out. And exhale, allow yourself to get more settled into the stretch, trying to pull the wrists down towards the ground. You can go ahead, straighten out the legs as well. And allow your body to sink deeper. Exhale, slowly release the fingertips back down towards the mat and walk yourself back into downward facing dog. Soften the knees, look towards the top of the mat and step both feet forward. From here, we're going to ragdoll all the way up. So release the head down, let it be heavy, and uncurl the spine vertebra by vertebra all the way up into standing. At the very top, roll the shoulders away from the ears and down the back. Palms face forward, Tadasana Mountain Pose. Feel the energy rising up from the earth, charging your body full of prana. And we'll go ahead and start with sun salutations. Bring your palms together at your heart center, big toes touching, heels slightly apart. On the next inhale, reach the arms up overhead, look up, exhale, hinge from the hips, fold forward. Inhale, fingertips on shins, halfway lift. Exhale, plant the hands, step back into plank pose. Take an inhale at the top. Exhale, slowly drop knees, chest, chin, elbows in. Inhale, hips down, chest up. Exhale, tuck the toes, push yourself all the way back into downward facing dog. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Look towards the top of the mat, step both feet forward, inhale, halfway lift, exhale, fold back in. Inhale, reach the arms up overhead, keep the spine straight, lean back, look up, And exhale, hands come down in front of your heart center. One breath in, one breath out. Inhale, reach the arms up overhead. Exhale, hinge from the hips, fold forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant the hands, step back into plank pose. Inhale at the top. Exhale, lower knees, chest, chin, elbows in. Inhale, hips down, chest up. Exhale, tuck toes, push back into downward facing dog. Breathing for 3 rounds of breath here. Soften the knees, look towards the top of the mat, step both feet forward. Inhale, halfway lift, straighten the spine. Exhale, fold back in. Big bend through both knees. Inhale, sweep the arms up overhead, lean back, look up. Exhale, hands come down in front of the heart. One breath in, one breath out. Inhale, reach your arms back overhead. Exhale, hinge from the hips, fold forward. Inhale, lift up halfway, straighten your spine. Exhale, plant the hands, jump back into plank this time. Inhale at the top. Exhale, lower yourself down, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, tuck toes, downward facing dog. 3 rounds of breath here. Soften the knees, look towards the top of the mat, jump both feet forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold back in. Inhale, reach the arms all the way up overhead, lean back, look up. Exhale, hands come down to heart center. A few rounds of breath here to get grounded once more. And on the next inhale, we'll reach the arms up overhead, sink low with the hips, finding Utkatasana chair pose, making sure your knees don't go past your toes, tuck the tailbone under to protect the lower back, engaging the abs, and sink deeper. Slowly bring your hands back down to heart center, thumbs towards the third eye, and we'll go ahead, twist over towards the right side, hooking left elbow over the right knee. Press the left elbow into the knee to twist the body, and check that your left knee is not sneaking too far forward, so bring it back in line with your right knee. One breath here. And inhale, we'll move through center, thumbs towards the third eye, and go ahead, twist over towards your left this time. Same thing, press the right elbow into the left knee, twist the body, and make sure that right knee is not sneaking too far forward. Bring it back in line. One breath here. On the next inhale, start to move back through center. We'll go ahead and release the hands straight back down towards the ground. Flatten the palms. Step the right leg, big step back into a high runner's lunge. Make sure you lift that right heel up off the ground, squeezing the inner thighs together. Sweep the arms back. On the inhale, sweep them forward and up into crescent lunge. Keeping both legs nice and engaged. And on the next inhale, spin the right heel down, open up the arms into warrior two. Looking towards the third finger of that left hand, steadying your gaze, keeping the hips nice and open, relaxing the shoulders away from the ears. Inhale, flip the left palm up and drop the right hand down on your right thigh. Reach the left hand all the way up and back to reverse your warrior, and sweep the right hand around the lower back, finding the hip crease of the left thigh. Continue to bend strong into that left knee, sinking low into your lunge. Slowly sweep the left hand forward. We're going in for bounded triangle. Straighten out the left knee. Reach the left hand forward until you can't reach anymore. Then drop the left hand down on top of the shin. Press the shin and use that to twist the body a little bit deeper. Slowly, you can also release the right hand back up towards the ceiling, finding good old Trikonasana triangle pose. Couple of breaths here. And to make it a little bit more tough, you can also sweep the left hand forward, making a 90 degree shape with your arms. Slowly release both hands back down towards the ground, framing that left foot. Spin the right heel off and step the right foot further forward to shorten the stance. We'll take an inhale to lengthen, and exhale to fold, keeping the lower back nice and straight. Then gently release, step the left foot back to meet the right and find downward facing dog. And we'll take one vinyasa here. Inhale, shift the body weight forward. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, back bend of your choice, cobra or up dog. Exhale, tuck the toes under downward facing dog. Bend the knees, look towards the top of the mat. Jump both feet forward. Inhale, we'll sweep the arms and find chair pose one more time, utkatasana. Quick alignment checks, make sure the knees don't go past the toes, tuck the tailbone under, engaging the abs and flattening out the lower back. Then we'll straighten out the legs, exhale, hinge from the hips, folding back forward, plant the hands and step the left foot back into a big step back, high runner's lunge. Lift the left heel high, drawing inner thighs towards each other, and we'll sweep the hands back, and on the inhale, rise up into crescent lunge. Then go ahead, spin the left heel down, open up the hips, open up the hands, find warrior two. Resting your gaze over the third finger of that right hand. On the next inhale, flip the right palm up, drop the left hand down on the left thigh, and lean all the way back into reverse warrior. Sink deep into that right knee. Then sweep the left hand around the lower back, find the hip crease of the right thigh. Continue to sink a little bit deeper, and on the next inhale, we'll start to reach the right hand forward towards the top of the mat. Straighten out the right knee, lean until you can't lean anymore, then drop the right hand down on top of the shin and press into the shin to help twist the body more open. When it's available, release the left hand straight up towards the ceiling, finding Trikonasana, triangle pose. If you like the added challenge, go ahead, float the right hand forward, making a 90 degree shape with your arms. And gently we'll release both hands back down towards the ground. Go ahead, shorten the stance, step the left foot slightly forward. Take an inhale to straighten out the right leg, straighten out the back, and exhale, hinging a little bit deeper over your straight right leg. Then release, step the right leg back to meet the left. Find downward facing dog, and we'll take one vinyasa here. Inhale, shift forward, plank. Exhale, slowly lower, chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, tuck your toes, downward facing dog. Step both feet together at the back of the mat, and on the next inhale, right leg rises up into three-legged dog. Lift the left heel high and start to bend the right knee in towards the chest, maybe tapping your nose with the knee, shifting shoulders over wrists, and setting the right foot down in between your hands. Charge through the legs, sweep both hands back behind you, and on the inhale, sweep them all the way forward and up, finding crescent lunge. Making sure that left leg is nice and engaged, the left heel is nice and high. We'll go ahead and shift the body weight forward, transitioning into warrior three, shifting the knee past the ankle, transfer the weight into the right leg and float the left leg all the way up. Drop the left hip, flex the left toes, and hold in warrior three. Place your hands at your heart center if you're struggling for balance, and we'll hold here for 3, 2, and 1. You can slowly release your hands back down towards the ground to support you, and we'll set the left foot right next to the right foot at the top of the mat. Inhale, we'll take a half lift, decompress the spine, and exhale, sliding your hands behind your ankles, pulling yourself deep into a forward fold. When you're ready, release the palms down into the mat, soften the knees, jump back into plank pose. Exhale, slowly lower yourself down, chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or up dog. exhale, tuck your toes, downward facing dog. Step both feet together at the back of the mat and inhale, lift the left leg up into three-legged dog. Bend the knee, pull it deep in towards your chest, tapping the nose and then setting the foot in between the hands. Making sure you're high onto that right heel, strong through the legs. We'll take an inhale and sweep the body all the way up into crescent lunge, sinking low into the left leg. From here, making sure the back leg is engaged, shift the body weight forward and start to transfer your weight over towards the left foot. Warrior three. Breathe deeply, hold the posture, continue to drop the right hip down and bring both hands towards the heart. Holding for another three, two, and one. Gently release your hands down to support you and step the right foot forward to meet the left. Inhale, take a halfway lift. Exhale, rounding all the way down, pulling yourself deeper into your forward fold. Gently release the backs of your ankles. Use your peace fingers instead to loop them around the big toe. Inhale to lengthen the spine and exhale, flare the elbows out. Pull yourself a little bit deeper. Hang out here for three, two, and one. Release, plant your hands and jump back into plank. Use your exhalation, ride the breath down, chaturanga. Inhale, slide forward into cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, tuck your toes, downward facing dog. A few rounds of breath here to get settled. And whenever you're ready, step both feet together at the back of the mat. And on the next inhale, right leg rises up. Exhale, bend the knee through towards the chest and step into a high runner's lunge. Spin the left heel down and sweep the arms up, rising into warrior one. Holding for three, two, and one. Release the hands back behind you, interlace the fingers. Imagine the energy pulling down towards the ground, rolling your shoulders away from the ears and down the back. Use your next exhalation to fold and hinge forward at the hips, finding humble warrior. You can rest your right shoulder on top of your right knee or float it on the very inside edge of your right knee using more core strength there. We'll hold this posture together for three, for two, and one. Slowly inhale, we can rise back up into standing. Continue to interlace the fingers, pull the hands back down towards the ground, and then gently release and sweep the arms up into warrior one. Good, now we'll spin off the right heel, point the toes parallel with the left, and then spin off the left heel, bend the left knee, and find warrior one on the other side. Good, sinking deep into the left hip, realigning yourself if you need to. And when you're ready, release the arms alongside the body, interlace the fingers, pull the wrists down towards the ground, shoulders roll back and down. On the next exhale, we'll start to hinge forward at the hips and try to bring that left shoulder on top of the left knee, or for more core engagement, float it just inside that left knee. We're also looking to increase the mobility in the shoulders here. So imagine those wrists pulling closer down towards the floor. And we'll hold here for another three, two, and one. We can start to come out of the posture very gently. Continue to pull the shoulders back and down. And release. Bring both arms up into warrior one. From here, we're turning the body forward in line with the hips. Pivot on the left heel, point both toes forward, and release your arms alongside the body. Then go ahead, place your hands on your hips here. Inhale to look up, straighten out the spine, and exhale, hinging from the hips, folding all the way forward into your wide-legged forward fold, or Prasarita Padottanasana. Take a couple more breaths here. gently, we can slowly release the grip from our hips and place the hands back down onto the ground. Come up onto fingertips, take an inhalation to lengthen the spine and exhalation to fold back in. One more time, inhalation, lengthen the spine. This time placing the right hand right down the middle of the mat as the left hand sweeps up towards the ceiling. Stack the shoulders. And if it's available, wrap the left arm all the way around the lower back, finding the hip crease of the right thigh. Then go ahead and allow yourself to settle into the stretch. And if you like a little bit of an extra twist, start to work your right hand out towards the left ankle. If you can't get the ankle, getting the knee is also fine, and then sliding it down towards the ankle. Bend the elbow, pull yourself deeper into the twist, look up. Couple of breaths here, and gently we can start to release. Right hand down, press the ground away, lift the body up halfway, untangle the left hand, and go ahead, replace the right hand with the left hand and reach the right hand up instead this time, switching sides. Flip the palm and wrap the arm around the lower back, finding the hip crease of the left thigh. Allow yourself to just get settled into the stretch. And if you want a deeper twist, crawl the left fingertips all the way over towards that right knee or right ankle. Bend the elbow and pull yourself into a deeper twist, looking up, using both that right hand and the left hand to twist yourself a little bit deeper. Gently release, left hand down, untangle the right hand, place both hands down. Inhale, lengthen, exhale, hinging at the hips, folding deeper. From here, you can place the palms in line with your ankles and slowly allow the weight to transfer into the crown of the head, maybe lifting the heels all the way up. And for those of you who are working on headstands or tripod headstands, this is a great way to start feeling comfortable on the crown of your head. We'll hold for a couple more rounds of breath and slowly we'll transition out of the posture. On your next inhale, push through the palms, straighten out the spine, stack the wrists underneath the shoulders, and then go ahead, walk the hands all the way over towards the right foot, pivot the toes forward, and step the right foot back into plank. From here, we'll take an inhalation at the top, and on the exhalation, simply drop the knees down towards the mat. Take the big toes to touch and press the hips all the way back and down, finding child's resting pose. Gently, we'll start to come into a little bit of a stretch here. Slide the right hand right down the middle of the mat as you sweep the left hand all the way backwards. Exhale, slide the left arm underneath the right, bringing left shoulder, left ear to touch the mat. Come up onto fingertips of the right hand and crawl the fingertips all the way over towards the left, floating that bicep on top of the ear, and stretch the shoulders out in opposite directions. Gently slide the right hand in front of your face, push the ground away, help yourself back up, and switch sides. Slide the left hand right down the middle of the mat as the right hand pulls back. And exhale, slide the right hand underneath the left, right shoulder, right ear touches the mat. Fingertips on the left hand crawl over towards the right side of the mat, twisting the body in both directions. Allow yourself to relax a little bit more into the posture. Enjoy the twist. And from here, sliding the left hand in front of your face, push the mat away and help yourself back up. We're going to transition onto our backs. Walk the knees towards the wrists, cross the ankles, roll over your sit bones, and make your way down onto your backs. Drawing the knees in towards the chest, give yourself a nice hug, and you can gently rock from side to side, massage out the lower back. And we'll pull the right knee in towards the chest, extend the left leg long down towards the mat. Then go ahead, twist the body, draw the right knee all the way across towards the left as you open up the right hand. And to deepen the stretch, we'll bend that bottom left leg, grab a hold of the ankle and pull onto the ankle. If you want to deepen the stretch, straighten out the right leg, grabbing the outside of the foot and allow your body to stretch. If you can't quite get the foot, you can also grab the outside of the knee. Stay here for a few rounds of breath. And gently release, rebend the right knee, release the left ankle, twist the body back to center, draw the left knee in towards the chest, and go ahead and switch sides. Extend the right leg long and slide the left knee all the way over towards the right. Open up the left hand, gaze to follow to complete the twist. Bend the right leg, grab a hold of the ankle or top of the foot, and option to also grab the outside of the left foot. Enjoy the twist here. Allow the breath to start to slow down as we wind down into the practice. Slowly we can release the stretch, bring yourself back to center, squeezing both knees in towards the chest, giving yourself a nice final hug. And we'll start to make our way down into Shavasana. Release the arms alongside the body, palms facing up, fingers in their natural curl, and extend the legs one by one. And lower them all the way down into the mat. As we come to rest here in our final posture of the practice, Shavasana, corpse pose. Allow your body to be heavy down into the ground and visualize the imprint you're leaving beneath you and in this world. You can continue to stay in Shavasana and allow the video to play on, or you can start to wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes, rock the hip from side to side, bring the heels together and stretch the arms up overhead into a big morning stretch, lifting the lower back off the ground, and exhale, releasing down. Rolling over to one side of the body and helping yourself back up into a seated position. It's been a pleasure leading you through this Hatha Basics class. I appreciate each and every one of you, and the light in me sees the light in you. Namaste. Thank you.
Why? Wow.